As you can see, I'm inside the boat now, which means I've completed the hull actually. I recently had to move to a new workshop, and for that I had to turn the hull around. That meant I didn't spend so much time doing videos, so now I have to catch up. So today I'm just gonna talk about completing the hull, and then I'll do another video about turning it around. The hull is basically covered with 6mm plywood. One panel is obviously too small to cover the entire hull, so they cut these puzzle joints into them. Problem was that the joints were too small, so I had to sand them to make them bigger. The two 3mm panels have to overlap, so I had to route in the rebate. In order to attach the panels to the hull, they are glued onto the stringers. First I just added plain epoxy and then also another layer of thickened epoxy to fill in any gaps. Later on, to make the connection really strong, I'm gonna add fillets on the inside. That the puzzle joints are large enough, I can join the panels together while adding them to the boat. In order to hold the panels down, I used weights sometimes, but also staples. The problem with the staples is that they have to come out again at some point, and that was a huge pain in the ass. The section is made of these small panels that you can see here. These didn't come pre-cut like the bigger ones, so I had to measure and cut them myself. After that, as before, put epoxy on the stringers and then use staples to hold the panels to the hull. Now that the first layer is on, I can glue the second layer onto the first one. The gaps between the panels got a bit larger from time to time, but as you can see, that wasn't really a problem. I just put in enough epoxy and sanded it down again. This is where the keel goes on later, so I have to add a few layers of fiberglass here.